Oh boy, oh boy, here we go. It's finally time to punch the last nail into this Yukari theory's coffin. There have been many strange things we have discovered, and now we just have to put the pieces together. So without any further ado, let us face and uncover the mysteries of this gap hack. Okay, straight to the point here. Do you still remember how I said in my last video that Yukari's behavior during the incidents changed after the establishment of the Hakurei barrier? And now the first question. What changed in Gensokyo when the barrier rose? One really important thing, forgotten by many but still in plain sight. And no, I'm not talking about the barrier itself, nor the fact that Gensokyo became isolated from the outside world, no. The thing that changed was that the Hakurei Shrine was established alongside with the barrier. Well, in fact, was established a little bit before the barrier, which gave the barrier its name, but anyhow. Yukari's behavior changed nevertheless, and here's why. The Hakurei Shrine Maidens and Priests started to take care of Gensokyo's incidents, and as you may remember, Yukari is the one aiding them. So what? Yukari formed her own little cult to take care of her problems. Well, no. She still takes direct actions from time to time when Gensokyo's balance is threatened by Yukai. And that's the other big thing, because Yukari is almost always siding with the humans instead of her own kind, which is very odd. But then we remember that she most likely is more than just a yukai, given the fact that she is unimaginably powerful, toppling most of the strongest yukai and gods. It is pretty clear that she is something else. And when we remember that possible Maribel connection, it becomes even more and more likely that she is not a yukai, or at least not an ordinary one. But just like I said, this video is going to be pretty short, so now I'm going straight to the point. When compared to the other shrines, mostly to Maria Shrine, what is lacking from the Hakurei Shrine? Any suggestions? Well, let me give you a hint. It is the most important thing for the shrine. The Hakurei Shrine is lacking its god. But now some of you may ask, but the Hakurei Shrine has the Hakurei god, doesn't it? To which I respond, yes, or at least it is supposed to have one. But now please tell me, what is Hakurei god's identity? Anyone? Any? No? Okay. That's right, Hakurei God's identity isn't known, even Reimu doesn't know it. In fact, the only person who has claimed to know the Hakurei God's identity is the one and only Rinosuke. But now, please, think about it very carefully. A shrine that is lacking a god, which priests and maidens are led by a yukai with seemingly unimaginably high levels of power, and the yukai even has a human side. The yukai is resembling balance in every way possible, and is helping humans to survive in the world of yukai, while still making the world habitable for yukai too. Doesn't it snap a bit too well in for Yukari? And don't you remember what Akio said about her powers, that they are godlike? Or what about the fact that only two characters besides Yukari that have had their own army are both gods? Could Yukari actually be the obscure Hakurei god maintaining the balance of Gensokyo? The balance between yukai and humans? Yes, yes, she really well could, given her actions and all these shady coincidences. I'd say that she actually is a god, the Hakurei god herself. Yukari, the god of, let's say, balance, created the Gensokyo when the humans started to forget about yukai, which threatened the balance. So she created a perfect utopia for humans and yukai to coexist in harmony. She then created the Hakurei Shrine to look over the world she created, and that shrine is dedicated to her, to Yukari, even if the maidens and priests do not know it or remember it, if it was a common knowledge in the past. We don't know why she has kept her identity as a god secret, but we could assume that if given away, it could threaten the balance between humans and Yuka in some way. Also, the faith from that shrine, even if it's not much, could explain her massive powers. And there you have it, a possible truth about Yukari. I bet that most of you guessed it before this episode, but it can't be helped. This has been by far the most massive theory I've yet made, and now I feel successful and pleased with the results. If this theory turns out to be true, it could have a huge impact to the lore of Touhou, for obvious reasons. But like always, please keep in mind that this isn't canon and this is just a theory. But be sure to leave a comment to this video about what you think about this. Do you think that Yukari could be the Hakurei god or not? I'd like to hear that. And also, if you have any theory ideas, be sure to leave them to the comments below. I'd love to read them. But now, when we have finally solved yet another puzzle, it's time to turn our gazes towards the future and the next video, where we'll meet again. So, till then, I have to bid you a farewell. My name is Teo Veijen, and we'll see in the next video.